Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Cinerama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire, brought to you by these generous local businesses. Nick Girash Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Cinerama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency, Summit Family Dental, All-Star Concrete, the Prairie Trail Sports Complex, Joe Bennett Homes, Ankeny Orthodontics, Rainbow of the Heartland, and West 40 Market. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Waukee Realtors, the 515 Agency, Springer Floor Care, Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital, Ted Sandine Photography, U.S. Cellular, Made in the Shade, Blinds and More, the Edward Jones Office of Kent Patterson, and Fiscus Jewelers.
Walks into Nick Girash Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching, we have the best technology, we have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
What does it mean for Lincoln Savings Bank to be more than a bank? You know how a library used to be a place you went to find a book using the Dewey Decimal System, which you never really understood? Well, the modern library is a place where providing access to books is one of many offerings. Lincoln Savings Bank is more than just a place you get your mortgage from and have your checking account. It is also a place you get insurance. It's a place you can get financial planning advice. It's a place you can do college planning. Have I made my point? Lincoln Savings Bank, more than a bank.
Good evening and welcome to Centennial Digital on the Central Iowa Sports Network, driven by Freedom Tire. Today and always, our pregame show is brought to you by Cinerama Ankeny, Signorama Ankeny is your full-service sign and graphics company. We design, produce, and install all type of exterior and interior signs, graphics for vehicles, including vehicle wraps, walls, windows, and doors. We also do banners, yard signs, business cards, real estate signs, trade shows and exhibit displays, flags, and more. Call us at 515-216-1240 or visit www.signorama-ankeny.com. And tonight we've got a fun doubleheader in store here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. It's the Waukee Warriors in town on the north side tonight here in Ankeny to take on Centennial. A top 15 matchup on both sides tonight, as here on the girls' side, it will be the number 14 Warriors and the number 6 Jaguars. We want to be sure and thank Weichert Realtors, the 515 agency, for presenting our girls' and boys' basketball coverage all season long. Matt Pazusta and Ryan Hoover were recently recognized with a Community Investment Award from the Ankeny Economic Development Corporation, and look forward to helping you buy or sell your next home. We will be back with the starting lineups here. It's the Warriors and the Jaguars right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses: Weichert Realtors, the 515 agency, Signorama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses: Nick Girosh Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Signorama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, an affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses: Weichert Realtors, the 515 agency, Summit Family Dental, All-Star Concrete, the Prairie Trail Sports Complex, Joe Bennett Homes, Ankeny Orthodontics, Rainbow of the Heartland, and West 40 Market.
As the pregame hype video rolls right now, we are ready to go tonight as the Waukee Warriors, ranked number 14th in the latest Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union rankings, and the number 6 Centennial Jaguars. An important game for seeding as we head to the postseason here tonight. The hype video is blasting. We expect a huge crowd here tonight in the jungle on the north side at Ankeny Centennial. Shortly we will have the starting lineups in tonight's game, and they are brought to you by 72 Degrees, 72 Degrees, the comfort company. And the next sound you will hear will be our public address announcer tonight, Cade Tomlinson.
Number 4, Jaden Burrett.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Cinerama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Nick Girosh Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Cinerama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC.
And there is our national anthem tonight, and we are about set for tip-off here between the Ankeny Centennial Jaguars, the home team tonight. They're in their white uniforms, bright white, trimmed in black, and Waukee out there in black, trimmed with white and purple. As we get set to go here, Coach Scott DeYoung, Hall of Fame coach for the Jaguars, and Coach Danny Franklin Printy out there tonight for Waukee Northwest. Waukee Northwest comes into the game tonight. They are 6-9 on the season, ranked number 14 in the latest IGHSAU polls. Ankeny Centennial ranked number 6. They are 12-4. Jaden Pratt set to do the tip-off for the Jaguars. Maya Crawford out there, as well as Kennedy White, Avery Porter, and McKenna Clark out for Waukee Northwest tonight. Tipping off things for them will be Sophia Hope out there, as well as Miranda Peters. Tip-off controlled, a little set play for the Jaguars and a layup right off the bat. Avery Porter knocks that one in with a layup, and the Jaguars out to a quick 2-0 lead. Waukee Northwest. Gentry Williams with a basketball out there to Miranda Peters. Back around here, it is Kristen Houck. Williams. Shot clock down to 15 now. Long three-point shot on the way. Good. Nothing but net there for Sophia Hope. The junior knocks that one through. And just like that, Waukee Northwest a quick lead. Clark with a basketball for the Jaguars. Down low they go to White, and White's going to be fouled. She's pushed from behind by Emily Sorensen, the sophomore, with her first foul of the night here, 49 seconds into the basketball game. First whistle of the night, Porter to trigger for Centennial. In quickly to Pratt, hands it off. White slices through the lane and knocks it through. Kennedy White, the leading scorer on this Jaguar basketball team at just over 10 points a game. Shoots 53% from the field, and a big part of that is because she finds herself under the lane for a lot of layups. Waukee, the Warriors. Kristen Houck with the basketball tipped away. It's going to go off Pratt and then Crawford and out of bounds. A couple sophomores there for Centennial. Future Division I basketball players. Multi-sport athletes. And now taking it out of bounds Northwest into Hope. Briefly looked at the three-point shot, handed it off to Houck. 7 seconds on the shot clock here for Hout. She's going to have to throw one up. They throw it up top, and they do not get it away, and a shot clock violation. Ball will get turned over back to Centennial. 90 seconds into this doubleheader tonight, and while this one should be good, the next one should be even better. The boys' action tonight between Waukee and Centennial. Omaha Baloo, the name today, a McDonald's All-American for Waukee, as McKenna Clark goes into the lane, can't get it to fall, and the rebound pulled out of there by Miranda Peters. Waukee Northwest looking to run with Williams. Down low, and we've got a foul called on McKenna Clark. An interesting matchup. The guards posting up on each other down there. Sorensen was trying to post up on Clark. Clark gets her first foul, whistled on her. They're on the inbounds once again up top for Waukee. This is Hauk. Swings it around to Williams. Long skip pass around. Working their way kind of against this matchup zone look. No, it is man-to-man. Looked like a 2-3 zone there for a little bit. Peters goes into the lane. 12 seconds on the shot clock here for Waukee. Long three on the way once again. No good, an air ball. Goes out of bounds, and the ball will be turned over to the Jaguars. Now later tonight, number two Waukee boys will be in action against the number seven Jaguars. A three-point game shortly before the holiday. Waukee got out to a huge lead, and Centennial came back and made it a great game. Three-point shot there from Clark, no good. And Peters clears the rebound. Waukee looking to run. Three-point shot on the way again, way short, and rebound tipped out of there, and Waukee comes away with it. Possibly a jump ball. Pratt on the ground, throws it up to Clark. And now Crawford pushing the tempo for the Jaguars. Up top to Porter. Now Clark down low. That's where Kennedy White wants to catch the basketball. She puts it through. Opportunity for the three-point play here for the Jaguars. Hope going to be whistled for the foul, her first. Kennedy White, a 73% free throw shooter on the season, and that one's strong, and the rebound cleared out of there by Peters for Waukee. Hauk with the basketball. In the high post, swing it back over, Hauk. Oh, down low, they got free on the screen. They got Hope, she puts up the shot, no good. Good play there for Waukee, just couldn't quite convert. Porter leaves it for Pratt. All the way into the lane, and Pratt is fouled, and she'll have a chance at the free throw line. Sorensen whistled for her second already. Not even halfway through the first quarter, so she'll likely have a seat on the bench. Jaden Pratt knocks the first one through. Pratt, a 71% free throw shooter. Mara Yokiel steps into the game for Waukee. Down low they go, and stolen away. Avery Porter with the basketball. Kicks it ahead to Crawford, running the floor. Up with a shot. Foul! The shot counts. Maya Crawford with a chance to complete a three-point play. Timeout for Waukee. Coach Franklin Pretty wants one. It's a 30-second timeout. We will keep it right here. Again, great opportunity right now to thank our presenting sponsor for the girls and boys basketball season here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. It's the Weichert Realtors, the 515 agency. They present our girls and boys basketball coverage all season long. Matt Pazusta and Ryan Hoover are there to help buy or sell your home, and they've got a great team over there that allow them to do that with great back office support as well. They were also recently recognized with a Community Investment Award from the Ankeny Economic Development Corporation, and look forward to helping you buy or sell your next home. Well, thank you to Matt and Ryan, as always, for their support of Centennial Digital. Just another business that's been great to make sure that all Ankeny Centennial activities get streamed here on Centennial Digital. All our home sporting events gives everybody a chance to watch. Crawford can't get it to fall. Rebound tipped out of there. A couple Warriors battling for it before Mara Yokiel comes away with it. And Waukee looking to try to find a basket, and they throw it away. They've really tried hard to get the ball down low. Sophia Hope They've been working to get the ball to her, a couple opportunities to get it to her. Just have not been able to get the ball through the hole yet. Kirsten Hauk, their leading scorer, at just under 12 points a game. Ava Martin in for our first Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution of the day. Kennedy White bullies her way into the lane, and they say she travels. White with just a couple little stutter steps as she worked her way through the lane in between the dribbles, and they got her for it. And that turns the ball back over to the Warriors against some press from Centennial. Hauk with the basketball. Into the lane, and a travel there as Dylan Peterson, the freshman, came around on the screen. Took a couple extra steps before she started dribbling, and another Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution as McKenna Clark back in the game as well. Down low they go. Jaden Pratt, two steps and a layup for Pratt. Little six-on-six move there. No dribble and was able to lay it in. And into the lane, nearly lost it there. Spin move up with a shot. Nice play there by Hope for Waukee. Quickly ahead, the Jaguars looking to run. Swinging it around up top. Now to Martin. Martin bullied out of the lane. Back up top to Clark. Here's Pratt. Porter. Long shot on the way from Clark. Good, McKenna Clark. Knocks that one through from three-point land. Our first Ankeny Real Estate Group three-point shot of the night. Into the lane, kicking out. There's Hope once again for three. The lefty in and out, no good. And Avery Porter, one of the shortest players on the court, goes up to get the rebound. Jags looking to run. It's Martin. To Porter to Clark. Blackmore into the game. There's a cutting Pratt up with a shot and good. So athletic, Jaden Pratt, as she cuts in the lane, and another timeout for Waukee. It's a full timeout. We'll take one as well and be back right after this. This is Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Time.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency. Summit Family Dental. All-Star Concrete. The Prairie Trail Sports Complex. Joe Bennett Homes. Ankeny Orthodontics. Rainbow of the Heartland. And West 40 Market.
Welcome back to the first quarter tonight, brought to you by the All-Star Concrete Team, specializing in all your commercial and street paving needs. Thanks to Alex over there at All-Star Concrete for his support of Centennial Jaguar Athletics, as the Jaguar Gals, number six in the state, trying to make a statement as we inch closer and closer to the postseason at halftime today. Stick around. We will have Taylor Anderson from the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union to talk a little bit about how the postseason seating works. And a big event coming up for them this weekend here in girls wrestling. Waukee with the basketball. Down low they try to go, and Pratt takes it away, tips it to Crawford. Pratt beat everybody down the court, but they couldn't quite get it to her. Martin's got the basketball right now. Martin hands off to Blackmore, coming around up top. Crawford, 20 seconds on the shot clock. Martin, Blackmore. Crawford into the lane, battles through some contact, and she's fouled, and they'll have a chance to shoot two. Really good crowd on hand so far, and we expect a big crowd here tonight, both from Waukee and Ankeny Centennial, as Waukee McDonald's All-American and future Iowa State Cyclone Omaha Blue will be in the house. In fact, he's already in the house. Saw him earlier. And he is electric, and the Jaguars will try to shut him down tonight in the boys' game. It's all Jaguars so far in this one on the girls' side. They lead 17-5, just over a minute to go in the first quarter. Jaguars could have a bigger lead right now if they could figure out a way to hit their free throws. Long three-point shot on the way there from Maranzalo, saved into the in. Zalo, another three-point shot on the way, and hits it. And actually, I take that back. The second one was Gentry Williams. First one was Zalo. The second one was Williams. Crawford now. Swings it around. There's Martin. Back to Crawford. McKenna Clark gets a couple extra steps there to take it down into the lane. Hands off to Crawford coming around once again. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Crawford drives in. It's blocked out of bounds, and the Jaguars, with 2 seconds on the shot clock, will have a chance here to knock one in. Don't have time to run a whole lot through this. Quick communication there as far as who's got Sophia Hope. 2 seconds as Porter looks to trigger it. Off the inbounds, Clark, and she's not going to get it off. Didn't have quite enough time to take those extra dribbles, and there's a shot clock violation with 18 seconds left. And hand the ball back over to Waukee. In there right now is Williams. Williams pushes it up the floor. All the way in up against White and blocked, and a foul called on Kennedy White. Good recognition there by Gentry Williams. She was one-on-one with White and took it right at her. And you can hear the voice of Hall of Famer Scott DeYoung letting everybody know, hey, you got to stop that basketball as they dribble it up the court. Loud student section scares everybody. The screams coming from the student section of Centennial as Gentry Williams leaves the first shot short. Easily puts the second one through. Waukee back to an 8-point lead. 10 seconds to go. Porter has it taken away nearly, and then a foul going to get called on Zalo. Jaguars, 7 seconds to go. Clark all the way in, leaves it tipped away, taken out of there, and Waukee not going to get a shot off. Jaguars, 17-9 lead after quarter number one. We'll be back with a second quarter right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency. Springer Floor Care. Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital. Ted Sandine Photography. U.S. Cellular. Made in the Shade, Blinds and More. The Edward Jones Office of Kent Patterson. And Fiscus Jewelers.
Welcome back to the West 40 Market. Second quarter, West 40 Market is your one-stop shop for individual cuts of Iowa-raised beef, pork, chicken, bison, turkey, and lamb, from ground meats, steaks, and beef snack sticks to brisket and roast. You'll love the variety of cuts they offer. Located at 315 Southwest Maple Street in Uptown Ankeny, they also carry a variety of local honey, rubs, jams, and sauces. Shop in-store or online for convenient pickup, delivery, or shipping nationwide. Follow them on Facebook or Instagram at West 40 Market. They are our second quarter sponsors here on Centennial Digital, and a local gem, West 40 Market. It was a group with a group of gentlemen just this afternoon, and we were talking about getting a brisket sometime in the near future and having a little neighborhood barbecue. Can't wait to do that. Love our stops at West 40 Market. Love loading up on beef snack sticks. Not just beef, pork snack sticks as well for the weekends. Good protein for our kids when they're off at their sporting events. Jaguars with the basketball right now. Porter kicks out. Crawford has a tough time hanging on to it. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Pratt. And shoved right back in her face, and Pratt takes it in, stolen away. And out of bounds, actually, with 4 seconds left. Thought Waukee might have had control of it. They didn't quite. And now it's Jaguar basketball with 4 seconds on the shot clock. Long possession here for the Jaguars. Porter. Ooh, they missed Pratt. There she is. They got her the second time. Missed her on the cut across the lane and then wide open on the inbounds play off the switch. And that has the Jaguar lead back to 10. Houck. Hands off to Peters. And then Hope with the basketball. Swinging it around. Down the corner, baseline move. That's where the Jags want to force you. Back up top to Houck, and she's able to drop it through. Excuse me, Hope drops it through. And the Jags looking to run. Crawford quickly back the other way, loses control of it as she goes up. Kennedy White briefly had the rebound and then taken away, and the Warriors look to run. Ooh, Houck thought about the three-point shot. Cuts back through, thought about it again down in the corner. Waukee spread out, a lot of spacing there, stolen away. Maya Crawford, the one on none, goes up with a shot and can't get it to fall. A little bit strong on the layup, probably should have just gone straight up. Coach DeYoung applauds her defensive effort, then Waukee quickly down. This is Williams with the basketball, they lob it down, and McKenna Clark's right there to take it away. Couple minutes here into the second quarter. Jaden Pratt to Porter, back up top to Clark and Crawford. Pratt again, Jaguars not moving a whole lot right now on offense. Then just when you least expect it, they make a cut. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Porter up top, Clark. Into the lane, free throw line, jump shot. Oh, wow. McKenna Clark, the pull-up from the free throw line. Sweetness right there for the Jaguars. Now Waukee tipped away. Ball goes out of bounds, and it's going to go to the Jags. A couple of gals got their hand on it. Off Waukee at the end. Now against a little token pressure there from Houck, it's going to be Clark with the basketball. Pratt wants her to use her screen. She does. Pratt once again up top. Crawford. Porter into the lane. Back to Pratt. Jaguars a lot of one-on-one tonight. Hand off to Crawford. Crawford throws the ball up off the glass. Mike Crawford just can't quite find the basket tonight. Waukee looking to run and swatted out of there by Jaden Pratt as Mari Yokiel finds out that going up against an elite all-state volleyball middle hitter isn't so easy as Jaden Pratt absolutely swats that one away. And a quick timeout. It's a full timeout for the Jaguars after the big block by Pratt. We'll take one as well and be back with more of the second quarter right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. And welcome back to second quarter action. It's the Jaguars leading Waukee 21-11 right now. Don't forget to stick around after the game to find out who our Lamberti, Goki, and Lucci Law Player of the Game is. Your local attorneys and a team to fit your legal needs. Reach out to us at LGL Law, 515-964-8777. or online at AnkenyLaw.com. Maya Crawford goes in and gets this one to fall off the steal. And it's the Jaguars by a dozen. Then nearly stolen away. It's going to go off Porter out of bounds. And a fresh 35 for Waukee. Tilly Smith now into the game. She was outstanding last week. Got some extended minutes. Very good shooter here for the Jaguars. Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital's substitution there for the Jags. And Waukee back on offense. Points are so hard to come by against this Jaguar defense. They force you into situations that you don't want to be in. Swing it around, three-point shot on the way. That's way strong there for Hope. And the Jaguars then can be patient on offense. Porter, though, realizes no one's on her, drives all the way in, floater in the lane, partially blocked, and then off Kennedy White's hand out of bounds. And that will go to Waukee. Waukee already with a nice presence here in their student section tonight. We expect a really big crowd here by the end of this evening. Waukee in some full court press. Halfway through the second quarter, a couple more Jaguars set to check in here shortly. Ooh, almost a travel there for Hauk. Down low they go, and shot no good. Good defense there by Clark, saves it in, and it's going to go out of bounds and stay with Waukee with 15 seconds on the shot clock. Maya Crawford and Finley Blackmore back in once again with our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Hauk going to set things up here for Waukee. 10 seconds on the shot clock, drives in, leaves it out for Peters. Peters can't get it to fall. And Jaden Pratt goes down to the ground. Looked like she might have hit her head on the floor, but she's up. Jaden Pratt finds herself on the floor a lot. A scrappy player in every sport that she plays. And since she did have possession, that will give the Warriors a fresh 35. Jaguars by a dozen right now. Down low they go, posting up. Sophia Hope, she got it really far down low. That's where they want to get it. Not able to convert, and Crawford beats everybody back, lays it up with the left hand, and too strong once again. And Maya Crawford a little frustrated right now on offense. She's had some of those shots to hit, can't quite get them to fall, but she's not letting it affect her defense. She has been getting steals and running the floor very well. Nearly gets another steal as she's drawn the assignment of Kirsten Hauk tonight, the leading scorer for Waukee. And then driving in there is Zalo. For Waukee, she's able to get the basket to fall and have an opportunity at the free throw. Blackmore for Centennial going to get whistled for her first. Just the third foul on Centennial, and we are nearing the end of the first half. And Zalo is able to convert the three-point play. Warriors back within single digits. McKenna Clark picks up her dribble in a bad spot right now. Swing it up top, and Pratt was on the line. We have an over and back, and the ball turned back over to Waukee. If you're watching this and you're somewhere in northern Polk County, there's still time to get here tonight. A few good seats remain. We're expecting a really big crowd here tonight for this one. Emily Sorensen with a basketball for Waukee. Couple more Jags set to check in. Crawford tips it away once again. Thought she might have tipped it off a Hauk, but she does not. Stick around for halftime. We will have Taylor Anderson of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union visiting with us. We'll also try to get as much of the halftime show here on the air as we can. The Jaguar Spirit Squad ready to do their performance for you here tonight. 19-foot jump shot on the way. No good there by Williams. And Pratt once again with a rebound for the Jaguars. Crawford. A couple of these sophomores, so much fun to watch for the Jaguars. Crawford once again up top to Pratt. Back to Crawford. They play catch with each other. Down low they go to White. Tipped away momentarily. Tilly Smith, another sophomore. Johnny on the spot there. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Crawford looking around, drives in the lane, has it stolen away. Warriors looking to run. Sorensen hands off to the lefty Hope. Sorensen three-point shot on the way, no good, and way high in the air is Jaden Pratt to get the rebound. 80 seconds to go here in the first half. Crawford. Pratt down low, they go quickly to Kennedy White, and the Jags just not completely in sync tonight on offense. Clark back into the game with our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Kirsten Houck down to the corner. Nearly swatted away, and she's able to knock it through. Houck is. And Waukee has it back to 7, under a minute to play in the first half. Jags haven't scored in a while, stolen away once again. Trying so hard to get the ball down low to Kennedy White, and then up on the break, can't quite get it to fall, is Houck, and then on the rebound. Believe we've got a foul on Miranda Peters. I believe we'll wait and see. It is Peters that they whistle. And that'll give the Jaguars an opportunity to shoot 1-1. Crawford was the one there getting the rebound. She'll have a chance here for the 1-1. Gets the first one to fall. Crawford lines it up once again and uses all the different parts of the rim to get it to fall through. And now 45 seconds to go against some pressure. Here's Hope. Down low it goes to Peters. There's about an 11-second differential between the shot clock and game clock. Houck quickly up with it, and she gets it to fall. Quick release there, and now the Jaguars will likely hold for one with a 7-point lead. Pratt. Off to Crawford, man. Up there, up top, they are being pesky, is Waukee. Porter gonna hang on to it for a little while. 10 seconds now, our clock there on the scoreboard, not official. It's close, but not official. Porter down to the corner, nearly tipped away, and Clark has it, she loses it. Waukee can't get a shot off. And the Jaguars just a little bit out of sorts on their last possession. But the Jaguars now lead 25-18 here as we go into the halftime locker room break. We'll be back with a Lincoln Savings Bank halftime show and Taylor Anderson of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Drosh Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
What does it mean for Lincoln Savings Bank to be more than a bank? You know how a library used to be a place you went to find a book using the Dewey Decimal System, which you never really understood? Well, the modern library is a place where providing access to books is one of many offerings. Lincoln Savings Bank is more than just a place you get your mortgage from and have your checking account. It is also a place you get insurance. It's a place you can get financial planning advice. It's a place you can do college planning. Have I made my point? Lincoln Savings Bank, more than a bank.
Welcome back to our halftime show here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. It's a 25-18 halftime lead for the number 6 Jaguars over the number 14 Waukee Warriors. I apologize. I think they called them Waukee. I think they called them Northwest a little bit early on. So still getting used to that transition right now. I've got with me right now Taylor Anderson of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. Taylor, it's always fun to get one of your representatives up here, and always fun to visit with you in particular. There's a lot of stuff going on right now as we work into our transition from the end. It's hard to believe, but we're really working towards the end right now of the winter sports season.
Yep, that's for sure. We've got an exciting month coming up here, starting off with our Super Regionals for wrestling. This is the first year we sanctioned girls wrestling. There was about 700 at the Iowa Wrestling Coaches Officials last year that competed, so we were We were hoping about 1,000. We thought 1,000 would be a wonderful number for this inaugural season. And right now in track wrestling, we got a little over 2,400. So the numbers doubled, which is a great problem to have. And so we'll have our super regionals at four sites this week on Friday. And then state wrestling will go to Coralville Extreme Arena the following week.
And
then,
we will be there. Central Iowa Sports Network will be representing the Girls Digital Network. So that will all be streamed this year. That will be fun to
do. And Pete and Justin and the whole crew of CISN doing a great job getting ready to put the show on the air.
So one of the things you talk about, these super regionals, I know we've got one locally here at Wells Fargo Arena. I saw Sioux City's got one at the Tyson Event Center. Where are the other super regionals being held?
Yep. So Sioux City and Hy-Vee Hall are the two, and then Decorah, Iowa.
Okay, yeah.
Northeast Iowa.
Yep.
And then Cedar Rapids.
Okay.
Eastern Iowa.
Yeah, sounds good.
So there will actually be two regionals at each site. So we'll have eight regionals and two at each site, and so we call it the old super regional.
And as you mentioned, 2,400 young ladies participating in wrestling this first season that Iowa has sanctioned it. What an awesome thing. There's been some, I know, like, for schools to add it on. I know with Centennial, in Centennial's case, they are with Ankeny and North Polk and Bondurant, I believe.
Yep.
And we've seen Valley with Adel and some other schools down there too. So just a great other opportunity for, you know, basketball is not necessarily a number sport.
Yep.
You
yep.
see
exactly.
8 to 9 girls have an opportunity to compete at varsity, but now with wrestling, just a whole other breadth of things for girls to do.
Absolutely. And we have currently in the state, I believe there's 188 programs. And those 188 programs consist of over 200 schools. And so cooperative sharing, it's one class. We want to make it as easy as possible for schools to get a program up and running. And it'll be interesting. I mean, by next year, I think we're looking at two classes already. And that might impact some of the cooperative sharing we do with wrestling, but it's definitely growing.
Not only what you guys have done here within the state, but you see many colleges and universities also starting to add it. So these opportunities for the girls, not just in high school, but then moves on into college.
Absolutely. And great feedback from a lot of programs that are starting a girls program at the collegiate level. They've been great to talk to. We recently had a Section 8 meeting in Chicago with a lot of the area state associations, and I believe, as Indiana said, they had their first inaugural girls state wrestling tournament. They're excited to have about 900 girls participating, and it came around to us, and we said, yeah, we're excited too. We got about 2,400 participating this year. So Iowa, you know, it's a state we're known for, it from Frank Gotch to today, and it just keeps growing.
So well, shifting gears a little bit here, we're drawing down right now. Just one more home game for Centennial. They do have a long road stretch here at the end of the year, but the end of the winter sports season with basketball, and really just an event known nationwide, the Iowa Girls High School Basketball Tournament. And no one does it better than what you guys do, and it's been awesome to be a part of it now for about the last 10 years as a broadcaster. But what an event that you guys have going on down at Wells Fargo.
It's exciting. That week at Wells Fargo, we move in the night before, and I think last year we got done setting up at about 1:32 in the morning.
And, well, if you need a hand this year, let me know.
Absolutely. We'll take it. We'll take it. It's been a great year of basketball. At one point, all five of the state champions were the top seed in each of their classes. And there's obviously, you know, there's a big game last week when Dowling and
Johnston. First loss in 42 games.
Yes, and Dowling's got the Hawks tonight, so it'll be interesting to see how that game comes out. But it's been a great year of basketball. Got some good teams coming, and we're getting close. And in between wrestling and basketball, we got the state bowling tournament up in Waterloo. So that's kind of the mid-mark there for this winter championship.
And I forget sometimes about the bowling. It's not an event that we cover a whole lot of, but I know there's another group of people that are doing that right now. And when I think of bowling, I'm thinking of going and watching a game while I'm there and enjoying a beverage and doing all that. Not the case, though, for these high school kids.
Absolutely. When I walked in there last year, I was looking for the nacho machine. I realized that there may not necessarily be one, but it's a great event and really showcase. Tournament. I mean,
okay.
So we host the boys and the girls simultaneously, and it's in Waterloo at two sites, team at one site, individuals at the other, and Waterloo does a phenomenal job hosting for us, and we're excited to get up there here in a couple weeks.
All right, well, thank you very much, Taylor Anderson from the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union here with us on the Lincoln Savings Bank Halftime Show. Always a pleasure, Taylor.
Great seeing you, Andy. Appreciate it.
All right, we'll be back right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency. Cinerama Ankeny. Discus Jewelers. Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC.
72 degrees, your comfort company. The New York Life Office of Josh Cowart. Rock Valley Physical Therapy. And the Iowa Rush Soccer Club.
What does it mean for Lincoln Savings Bank to be more than a bank? You know how a library used to be a place you went to find a book using the Dewey Decimal System, which you never really understood? Well, the modern library is a place where providing access to books is one of many offerings. Lincoln Savings Bank is more than just a place you get your mortgage from and have your checking account. It is also a place you get insurance. It's a place you can get financial planning advice. It's a place you can do college planning. Have I made my point? Lincoln Savings Bank, more than a bank.
And welcome back to the Lincoln Savings Bank Halftime Show. For over 120 years, Lincoln Savings Bank has been loving the people we work with and the customers we serve with locations all over Iowa. LSB offers commercial and retail banking, mortgage, insurance, and wealth management, along with an award-winning small business lending team. Proud to be a part of the Ankeny and actually Waukee communities as well. For over 10 years, Lincoln Savings Bank member FDIC. Here at the halftime break, it is Centennial 25. And Waukee 18, Jaguars led at the end of the first quarter 17-9, a pretty low scoring second half. A close one going on here on the south side of town here tonight. You can also catch that game on the Central Iowa Sports Network. Dowling, who is coming off a big upset of Johnston here on Tuesday night, they lead Ankeny 30-27 in a top 10-ish game right now. I think Ankeny is back in the top 10, so if you have to switch back and forth, they're also showing right now on the Central Iowa Sports Network. As I flipped over there, the Maroons just hit a three to go up 33-27. We want to thank everybody for watching so far here tonight and tell you a little bit about Iowa's premier indoor youth sports facility. It is open right now this winter here in Ankeny. The Fieldhouse at the Prairie Trail Sports Complex. They'll be offering boys and girls basketball tournaments, volleyball tournaments, hit tracks leagues for softball and baseball. Visit ParadeTrailSC.com for details on tournaments. They've got a lot of them coming up, I know. Leagues, other events, pickleball daily there, and all the other stuff going on in the Ankeny community. Visit them once again at ParadeTrailSC.com. And also, we just had our look around the CIML tonight, and that was powered by U.S. Cellular. At U.S. Cellular, we care about our customers and communities. As always, tonight's live stream is powered by U.S. Cellular's blazing fast 5G network. They keep our whole show on the road. Many, many cameras hooked up through that network, located just north of Northview Middle School and right across from the Ankeny Sonic. Come check out America's locally grown wireless at U.S. Cellular. That's our Lincoln Savings Bank halftime show, and it's time now for our second half action. Here in the Rainbow of the Heartland, third quarter, parents and grandparents, check out Rainbow of the Heartland and Grimes for the best in swing sets, basketball hoops, courts, and trampolines. They also offer commercial playgrounds and have been Iowa's playground superstore for 25 years. Call 1-800-RAINBOW or visit rainbowoftheheartland.com. Jaden Pratt goes to the left hand, can't quite get it to fall. Good defense there by Peters. And clearing it out for Northwest is Hauk. Might have some issues as the Waukee student section is filled in right now. Hopefully we can get all the action down there as McKenna Clark comes in on the weak side, comes away with the steal, pushes over to Pratt. Clark to Pratt. Clark, 15-foot jump shot, can't get it to fall. Kennedy White rips away the rebound. She's going to get fouled on the floor. And they're going to get Hauk. Just her second, first foul of the half here on Waukee. 7:11 to go in the third quarter. Porter looking to get it in, does to Crawford. Things have been very spread out for Centennial here tonight. Porter with the basketball, back to Clark. Back to Porter. Three-point shot away from Crawford. Don't see that a whole lot. Lets it loose. Way up high is Pratt for the rebound. A lot of contact, nothing called, and quickly out of there for Waukee. Sorensen's got it right now. And then nearly taken away by Crawford. Set to trigger once again are the Warriors. And it's taken away. Avery Porter hustles all the way down and has it taken away from her. Dribble went off a hard part of the court. Ball went way high in the air and she had it taken away. Now Waukee into the lane. Nearly a travel there for Williams. And she sets things up again. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Sorensen into the lane, tipped out of there, and the Warriors will maintain possession. Waukee now with the basketball under their own hoop. That's Houck to trigger. She throws it in. As the Warriors set things up, it's Houck. Up top it goes, Williams. And Hope, 3 seconds on the shot clock. Long three on the way there is no good by Peters. And the Jaguars once again force Waukee into a long bad shot off their possession. Crawford up top to Clark, Porter. Pratt's going to let loose a three-point shot. In and out, back in, it's good. The shooter's touch for Jaden Pratt. Definitely in contention for our Lamberti Goki Lucci Law player of the game. Peters. Waukee. Houck up top, stolen away. Crawford, look out. Maya Crawford all the way down, goes up with a shot, can't get it to fall, but she's the only one there. A little mic and drill to herself there for Crawford. And it's back to the Jaguars by a dozen. Maya Crawford has been a welcome addition to this Jaguar squad this year. Down to the corner and travel down there, and I'm having a tough time seeing that corner. That's going to be Gentry Williams, I believe, that traveled with the basketball. Couple substitutions all over. Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitutions. Thank you to Dr. Stacy Munger and crew who bring those substitutions to you. Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital. Ava Martin checks into the game for the Jaguars as Kennedy White will have a seat. Jaguars have gone eight deep tonight on the bench. That ball tipped out of there by Zalo for Waukee. Quick update from the south side. Dowling has extended their lead here towards the end of the third quarter. They lead right now 39-31 Dowling has extended their lead over Ankeny. They lead by 10 now, right at the end of the third quarter as they head in, and now Ava Martin travels with the basketball. So back to Waukee with the basketball. Ball nearly sneaks away there from Dylan Peterson, the freshman, now into the game. And 3.5 minutes into the third quarter. Not sure what the discussion is right now. He wants to make sure that official wants to make sure that all the uniforms are tucked in. So Waukee back with the basketball. Houck with the basketball. Coming off of the screen from Zalo. Back in, stolen out of there. Man, Maya Crawford, you just cannot relax with the basketball around her. Ahead to Porter, the floater in the lane, can't get it to fall. Who else but Maya Crawford there keeping it alive. On the floor is Pratt. And Coach Scott DeYoung wants a timeout. He's going to be granted it. A timeout for the Jaguars. It is a 30-second timeout. We will take a timeout as well and be back right after this on the Rainbow of the Heartland third quarter.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire, brought to you by these generous local businesses: Dick Girosh Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Sinorama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC.
And welcome back about halfway through the third quarter here. Quickly on the inbounds play, once again, the Jaguars threatening off the inbounds. Jaden Pratt has the ball blocked away, but there is going to be a foul whistled on Emily Sorensen. Her third foul is said Jaden Pratt got hit in the head. Pratt sets it up for the free throw, and she's got it. Biggest lead of the night here for the Jaguars at 13. Pratt eyes it once again, can't get that one to fall. Tilly Smith tries to keep the rebound alive, and Maya Crawford drives that basketball out of bounds. It will remain with Waukee, but now they've got to set it up underneath their own basket. Inbounds there goes to Houck. Some token pressure there from Porter. Down low, they go back and way down up with a shot. Very easy there for Sorensen. She was able to catch the ball down below the block. Easy put in there for Sorensen. And Waukee has it back to an 11-point lead for the Jaguars. Clark over to Crawford. Back to Clark. Clark all the way in. She's fouled. So they got her with a body. That's going to be on Peters. Sophia Hope back into the game. Jaguars by 13 here in the third quarter. As they try to get it in there to Hope. Hands off Zalo. Back up top. Three-point shot on the way. It looked right on line here from Sorensen. And off the rebound, up off the glass, no good. As Sophia Hope, though, will have a chance at the free throw line. Kennedy White going to be whistled for her second foul. And now the ball turned back over to the Jags. Pratt back into the game for the Jags. In our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution as we approach the three-minute mark of the third quarter. This Rainbow of the Heartland third quarter. Clark to Martin and Pratt. Pratt off the pick and roll, but Waukee all over the place, and somehow Kennedy White muscles the ball up through there, gets the and one. And she did a great job muscling it through, but then being soft off the glass. Third foul there on Peters. White gets it to fall. Biggest lead of the night for the Jags right now at 14. Waukee with the basketball now in their black uniforms. That's Houck with the ball. Off a lot of contact there from Porter. Drives in, swings it around. This is Peters' three-point shot on the way. No good, and a huge box out there. And they're going to say Kennedy White got too physical. And we had a scoreboard operator off by a point, but I guess here on the stream we were right. Thought for a while we might have been off by one, but they just made the adjustment on the scoreboard. So it is the Jags by 15 now as Jaden Pratt comes away with a steal. Ava Martin all the way in and gets the contact, and she'll have a chance for two free throws. Foul on Sophia Hope. Ava Martin for the Jags. Chance at the free throw line for a couple. Rims that one out. Another Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution, Finley Blackmore, into the game for the Jags now. Martin, that one's strong. Man, Jags have not found the range at the free throw line here tonight, but they continue to play great defense. In fact, just 3 points allowed for Waukee here in this third quarter. Hope and Jaden Pratt runs through the screen there. It's happened to her before. Jaden Pratt is fearless out on the floor. And she ran through Emily Sorensen, got whistled for the foul. Crawford back into the game. Some more fans continue to file in here tonight. Zayla with the ball for Waukee. Into the lane she goes. Down to the corner, 3-point shot for Hauk, no good. And nice box out there for Waukee. They keep it alive, up with a shot, good, as Emily Sorensen gets it off the glass. Back to a 13-point lead for the Jaguars. Crawford hands off to Porter, back to Martin. And down low they go. Ava Martin open under the glass. Knew she was, put it up off the glass, and good. And a timeout for Waukee. Full timeout. We'll take one as well. This is Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency. Summit Family Dental. All-Star Concrete. The Prairie Trail Sports Complex. Joe Bennett Homes. Ankeny Orthodontics. Rainbow of the Heartland. And West 40 Market.
Welcome back to the Rainbow of the Heartland third quarter. Make sure to visit 1-800-RAINBOW or their website at rainbowoftheheartland.com to find out all about their basketball hoops, courts, trampolines, commercial playgrounds, swing sets. You see their stuff all over the place. The Armstrong family, welcome them to our Centennial Digital family of streams. 38-23, Jaguars in the lead here with a minute 35 to go in the third quarter. They led 17-9 at the end of the first, 25-18 at halftime after kind of a struggle to put points on the board in the second quarter, and now lead 38-23. Some pressure here for the Jags against Waukee. Minute and a half to go in the third. Sophia Hope. Hands off there to Hauk. 3-point shot on the way, no good. And Maya Crawford up high to get the rebound for the Jags. Jaden Pratt going to run the point guard position here for the Jaguars. She's waiting for someone to come up and take the ball from her. Just kind of stops and waves, says, someone come take this. Martin with the basketball. Down to the corner they go. Blackmore in the game now. Under a minute to play in the third. Down low they go to Pratt. And hard pass out to Martin. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Martin, and stolen away. Good defense there for Waukee by Kirsten Hauk. Sorensen hands off to Hauk. Into the lane and throws it away. That'll be a fresh shot clock and no shot clock actually now with that 35-second shot clock with 33.7 seconds to go. In the third quarter, Jaguars get some shooters in the basketball game. McKenna Clark on the crossover, hands off to Crawford, and a foul away from the basketball. I think Jaden Pratt was fouled. They said, yes, she was. Emily Sorensen with a little shove, and that is a fourth foul on Sorensen. One of the starters tonight for the Warriors. 23 seconds now on the game clock. Porter down in the corner. McKenna Clark spots it up. Lets loose a 3-point shot. Can't get it to fall. And Marin Zalo gets the ball back for Waukee. Down low they go. Spin move there for Hope. That's good. She's done a nice job down low. Sophia Hope has it back to a 13-point lead. 3 seconds. Blackmore, Pratt at the horn. No good. Jaguars by 13 as we head to the fourth quarter. Back after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Time. Welcome back to the fourth quarter here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. After the game tonight, we'll be heading over to the Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill to celebrate, hopefully, a couple Jaguar victories. Was there for lunch today. The Cabaret has great tenderloins, wraps, tacos, you name it, they've got it there on the north side of Ankeny. Stop by after the game or anytime, really. Open every day, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill in Ankeny. As Waukee will start off this fourth quarter with the basketball, trailing by 13. Hope. Hauk now with the basketball for Waukee. They swing things around. Long time here, 8 seconds on the shot clock. Up top, this is Peters. Peters drives in. She's not going to get the shot from there. And then a long shot there from Gentry Williams, no good. And Maya Crawford again there for the rebound. She's got a bunch. Jaguars push it ahead. Kennedy White run to the floor, knocks it through one more time. And this is equal to biggest lead of the night for the Jaguars. Hope trying to work on Pratt. Down low they go, and Hope. It's behind the defense. And she kicks it back out. Good defense there. Good help there from Crawford. Pratt team up there after Hope caught it down on the block. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Three-point shot no good. Fresh 35 for Waukee. Three-point shot on the way. No good there by Williams. And Waukee again battles for the rebound. Then hard to the ground is Maya Crawford off the jump ball. And good sportsmanship shown there by Sophia Hope. Checks with Crawford, make sure she's all right. Just some very physical play right there by a couple very competitive young ladies. Jaden Pratt as she tries to get it in, and McKenna Clark is going to get fouled, and that is 7 right now on Waukee. And means McKenna Clark will have an opportunity for a 1-1. Hout gets whistled for her third. And now a discussion here at the scorer's bench about how things are going to get done. The officials come together. Little discussion down here, and they seem to have it figured out. Not sure what that was all about. Sometimes we can catch in those conversations, but a big crowd and a big buzz here in the gym tonight. Not able to find that one. And McKenna Clark rims out the free throw and off the rebound. And Jaden Pratt kept it alive, and Hope not able to hang on to it. Out of bounds, and that will stay with the Jaguars. 34 seconds on the shot clock. Avery Porter takes the basketball out of bounds, throws it in, and it's tipped out of there. Thought it might have gone off of Pratt. It did. Yeah, Gentry Williams tipped the basketball. It went off Jaden Pratt and out of bounds, and now the Warriors will get the basketball back. So three different possessions in about 2 seconds. As Waukee pushes it ahead. Zayla with the basketball, and she's fouled by Clark. Fourth team foul on Centennial. Don't forget to stick around after the game to find out who our Lamberti, Goki, and Lucci Law Player of the Game is. Your local attorneys and a team to fit your legal needs. Reach out to us at LGL Law, 515-964-8777, or online at ankenylaw.com. Big announcement from LGL Law here in the very near future as well. Stay tuned to Centennial Digital for that. Three-point shot on the way there from Peters is no good. And once again, Jaden Pratt corrals that rebound. Clark back to Pratt. Under six to play. Porter back to Clark. Her three-point shot a little bit strong, but Pratt right there for the rebound. She decides to dribble it out, and she's actually going to get granted a timeout as Coach Scott DeYoung came in right away and said he wanted a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep take one. We'll keep it right here, excuse me. Couple looks around the league right now to see what else is going on, courtesy of U.S. Cellular and their blazing fast 5G network. Ankeny made a run in the fourth quarter, but now with under 20 seconds to go, Dowling back in the lead, 52-42. Boy, the Dowling Catholic girls are red hot right now. They just they keep finding more and more ways to win. And they beat Ankeny here tonight. Looks like Dowling's at the free throw line right now as we look at that one. We've also got Iowa State basketball tonight. Big game going on up in Ames. I know a lot of Iowa State fans will be tuning into this one as well, watching the stream of their future star, Omaha Ballou of Waukee. Clark off the set play, three-point shot. That is pretty. As Clark drops that one through our Ankeny Real Estate Group three-point shot, visit their website, ankenyrealestate.com, to find out your three ways to sell your home in Ankeny. And then what a move there by Emily Sorensen. Gets that to fall. And she'll have an opportunity at a three-point play. Excuse me, I said that wrong for the Ankeny Real Estate Group. Their website is liveankeny.com. Find out their three ways to sell your home with them. Is that three-point shot no good? And once again, Jaden Pratt there for the rebound. Pratt with the basketball. Off to Clark. Jaguars by 16 right now. Off to Crawford as we approach the five-minute mark here of the fourth quarter. Porter off to Clark once again. She is on right now. Michael Heider and Colin Panzi at the Ankeny Real Estate Group can thank McKenna Clark for their name being brought up a lot tonight. Three-point shot on the way there is banked in. It's the Lincoln Savings Bank shot. Gentry Williams knocks it in. Back to a 16-point lead for the Jags. Pratt wanted to shoot it. Clark, heat check. That one was a little bit long. Crawford there, though, for the rebound. Back to Clark. And the Jaguars going to slow things down a little bit. 30 seconds on the shot clock, an opportunity to knock this clock off a little bit. Jaden Pratt. Now to Crawford, back to Clark. Down low they go. Maya Crawford sneaks behind everybody. Saw the opening and just snuck through it. And another layup for Maya Crawford, and it's the Jags by 18. Under four to play. And on the three-point shot, a foul there. Kirsten Hout going to have an opportunity for a three-point play. Avery Porter going to get whistled for the foul as the basketball went all the way down to the other end. The Jaguar cheer squad there to throw it back in. This is just game one of our doubleheader here tonight. A top 10 matchup coming your way next with the number 2 ranked Waukee Warriors boys team and the number 7 Centennial Jaguar boys team. It was a 3-point game when these two teams played shortly before the Christmas break. as the second one goes through there for Hauk. Gentry Williams back in the game for Waukee. Both teams have struggled a little bit at the free throw line here tonight. McKenna Clark now with 3:45 to play. Down low they go to White. She draws the attention of three Warriors. Gets her own rebound, though. And then an interior pass there to Porter. No good. They swing it around and a little bit strong there as they try to get it to White. And you hear the voice of Scott DeYoung say, calm down. Let's everybody know, just slow down a little bit. You lead by 17 with 3.5 minutes to play. Hauk with the ball. This is Williams, back to Hauk. Swing it around once again. That's Williams for three, no good. Long rebound, and McKenna Clark comes away with it. Quickly up top, she goes to Porter. Pratt, now they slow things down a little bit. 25 seconds on the shot clock, an opportunity to milk that clock a little bit. Clark. Swing it around once again. Porter. Hands off to Pratt. Pratt all the way in, has it blocked away. Kennedy White gets the rebound up with the left hand. She's fouled at the horn. Kennedy White off the rebound. Gets fouled as she goes to the left hand. And she'll have a chance to shoot two free throws. White gets that first free throw to fall. Second one as well, and it's up to a 19-point lead, equals the biggest lead of the night for the Jags. And there's going to be a foul whistled there on Pratt, I believe it is. And that will send Sophia Hope to the free throw line. There'll be about a 15-minute break between games as the boys warm up, and we will be back with their action as we'll step away just briefly, and then we'll be back with their action very soon. Hope gets a second one to fall as well. Pratt. Hands off to Crawford, up top to Porter. Back to Pratt. A little cut there to Porter, and back up top to White. Jags going to reload. McKenna Clark looks over things now. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Porter. Jags not even worried if they don't get a shot off here. And into the lane and blocked out of there, and a foul going to be whistled on Gentry Williams. And now Jaden Pratt will have a chance for two more. Excuse me, Mara Yokeel. Got my 24 and my 14 mixed up there, Yokeel. And the Jags just can't get those free throws to fall tonight. Pratt, future Division I athlete, whether she chooses to go with volleyball or basketball, puts that one through, and it's back to an 18-point lead for the Jaguars. Minute 40 to go. Sophia Hope, spin move in the lane. That's nice, man. Sophia Hope, the junior, some ball skills there for Waukee as the Jags get it ahead. Crawford, move down here from Cedar Falls. Her father, Eric, on the basketball coaching staff at Iowa State, has been a huge pickup for the Jaguars here in this offseason. huge boost to the energy on the floor. As Kennedy White's got it now, back to Crawford. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Crawford, the floater in the lane, gets it to fall. And so many times tonight, the Jaguars have been able to work that shot clock down and then attack and get a foul or a bucket at the end. And that's Crawford with a sweet kiss off the glass there. And she can't get it to fall either. I think they gave the points to the wrong team on the scoreboard, actually, after that. As Clark dribbles in, and another foul whistled on Waukee. A couple more free throws here for the Jaguars. So McKenna Clark will head to the free throw line now. There we go, got that lid off the rim for the free throws. So 54-35 is our score right now. Make it 20. As that time will tick down, we'll take about a 15-minute break after our brief postgame show and be back with the boys' action. Top 10 matchup coming up very soon. Into the lane, Yokeel, and they say she's fouled by Kennedy White. A lot of fouls whistled in this one tonight. We've seen games where it's got extremely physical. This is not one of them tonight. Not a whole lot of wiggle room there. It's been consistent all game long, but the fouls have been called the entire time. Yokeel hits that one. And the Jags now, the shot clock is off. 20 seconds to go in this one. Fans stand up, applaud the effort. Jaguars going to win this one tonight, leading by 19 now. We'll see if it stays that way. Clark counts it off. Waukee backs off. She'll just be able to hold it there, and that'll do it. The Jaguars, the final tonight, 55-36. Take a quick moment, and we'll be back with our post-game show right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Cinerama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC. 72 Degrees, your comfort company. The New York Life Office of Josh Cowart. Rock Valley Physical Therapy. And the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Nick Girash Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Cinerama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC.
And welcome back to our postgame show tonight, where the Centennial girls, number 6 in the state, were victorious over number 14, Waukee, 55-36, the final. And the Jaguars will improve right now on the season to 13-4. Waukee drops to 6-9. Time to name now our Lamberti, Goki, and Lucci Law Player of the Game. Your local attorneys and a team to fit your legal needs. Reach out to us at LGL Law, 515-964-8777, or online at ankenylaw.com. And our LGL Law player of the game tonight is Jaden Pratt. Sophomore Jaden Pratt was outstanding, lots of rebounds, and finished early on for the Jaguars. It was between her and McKenna Clark, and we gave the nod to Pratt tonight. So the Jaguars led 17-9 after one, 25-18 at halftime, 38-25 after the third, and the final tonight, 55-36. We're going to step away for about 10 minutes, and then we'll be back with the pregame show for the boys' game coming up right after this. This is Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire, brought to you by the generous local businesses. Nick Girosh Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Dinorama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency, Summit Family Dental, All-Star Concrete, the Prairie Trail Sports Complex, Joe Bennett Homes, Ankeny Orthodontics, Rainbow of the Heartland, and West 40 Market.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Jerosh Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
Good evening and welcome to Centennial Digital on the Central Iowa Sports Network, driven by Freedom Tire. Andy Pollack with you tonight as it is number two Waukee. Maybe they should be number one. We'll find out as the season goes on tonight in town, hosted by the number seven Ankeny Centennial Jaguars. Today and always, our pregame show is brought to you by Signorama Ankeny. Signorama Ankeny is your full-service sign and graphics company. We design, produce, and install all types of exterior and interior signs, graphics for vehicles, including vehicle wraps, walls, windows, and doors. We also do banners, yard signs, business cards, real estate signs, trade shows and exhibit displays, flags, and more. Call us at 515-216-1240 or visit www.signorama-ankeny.com. And tonight it is, like I said, the Waukee Warriors in town. They are 13-2 on the season. They are currently ranked number two in the latest Iowa High School Athletic Association poll. The Centennial Jaguars are ranked number seven. A lot of star power follows this Waukee Warriors squad into the gym here tonight. Omaha Blue, their senior guard, averages just under 23 points a game and just found out today that he was named a McDonald's All-American. Blue, the future Iowa State Cyclone, missing his Cyclones up in Ames playing tonight, but the Jaguars will have a tall task with him here tonight. Luke Winkle, the leading scorer for the Jaguars. Luke, just a junior, averaging just under 16 points a game, and a very, very good guard and very good job at getting to the basket for Luke Winkle. Shortly before the Christmas break, these two teams met. Waukee sprinted out to a 19-1 lead. Looked like it was going to be a long night for the Jaguars, and at the end of the game, just enough was done by Waukee, and the Jags only lost by three in that game. So we'll see if they can keep the hot hand tonight. The Jags, very, very good from three-point land. They shoot almost 40% from three-point land on the season. So we'll see if they can do that. They'll need some of those tonight if they're going to stay in the game versus the number two Waukee Warriors. We'll be back with the starting lineups right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses: Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Signorama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire, brought to you by these generous local businesses: Nick Jerosh Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Signorama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC.
Welcome back. They are playing the hype video right now, and it's soon time for our starting lineups. In today's game, they are brought to you by 72 Degrees, 72 Degrees, the comfort company. And the next voice you will hear is of public address announcer Cade Tomlinson. There you have it. Our starting lineups brought to you by 72 Degrees. 72 Degrees, the comfort company, as we get set to go with things here tonight. And a ton of fans. It is a raucous crowd here at Ankeny Centennial. Waukee Warriors have brought a huge student section around as well. As we get set to go out there for Centennial here tonight, Chase Shuddy will do the honors here for the starting lineups. And out there for Waukee, it's going to be Omaha Ballou. He will jump it up against Shuddy, Mason Costello in the game, Cooper Randall, Vance Pfeiffer, and Cade Littlefield as well right now in the game for Waukee to get things started. And the tip controlled by Waukee. Cooper Randall's got the basketball as he hands off to Mason Costello. Costello dribbles around, up top it goes to Littlefield, to Ballou, the McDonald's All-American. Ballou covered by Schurz. Good defense there by Drew. They try to get it down to Littlefield, they do. And ball tipped away there momentarily. Jags all over the place on defense. Ball nearly thrown away into the backcourt. Randall's got it, now down to the corner. Three-point shot on the way, no good. And the rebound hustled out of there, tipped away, and it is going to stay with the Warriors. Tonight's first quarter is brought to you by the All-Star Concrete Team, specializing in all your commercial and street paving needs. Thanks to Alex and team there. And ball taken out of there for the Jags. Luke Winkle looking to push things now. Winkle hands off Evan Bryan for three. The knuckleball drops through. And we've got our first Ankeny Real Estate Group three-point shot of the night. Cade Littlefield with the basketball, throws it down to Pfeiffer. And he drops it through from just inside the three-point line. Luke Winkle now with a basketball. Huge crowd on hand here tonight, and it's a loud one. Hopefully you can hear my voice. If not, just enjoy the picture. Winkle throws it up top. Back to Schurz. Schurz. Shot. Man, that's a smooth-looking shot. Can't quite get it to fall as Pfeiffer comes away with a rebound. Waukee on the attack. They know where Ballou is at all times right now. Down they go to him. They try to trap him. That's going to be a tough to do as well. Three-point shot on the way from the corner. And Mason Costello just lays it right in. And Waukee now is in the lead for the first time tonight. Winkle with a basketball, thought about three. I think Ballou would have put that right back in his face. Evan Bryan right now goes into the lane, has it swatted away momentarily. Shot up and no good. Rebound out of there for Waukee. Cooper Randall pushes it ahead. Littlefield into the lane, has to throw it back out. And ball tipped away. Winkle got a hand on it. Waukee hustling around. They've got it down low. They go open down there is Costello, and he lays it in. Jags got lost in a little bit of transition. 7-3 Warriors. Winkle covered by Ballou. Kicks it out. Shuddy thought about three. Winkle drives into the lane. Kicks it, gives it off to Evan Bryan off the glass and good. Luke Winkle creating. Waukee looks over to their head coach, Kevin Kinaski, gets the signals. Ballou hands off, set shot there from Littlefield is good. So the Jags have held Ballou scoreless through about half of the first quarter. It doesn't matter because the rest of the Warriors are rolling. If you see our shot vibrating, it's the Waukee student section all over the place. Evan Bryan into the lane. Drops it through. He stays hot, remains hot from his game on Friday night. Costello kicks it out, three-point shot on the way. Good once again, Cade Littlefield. Waukee on fire from three here early on. Luke Winkle throws out, stolen away. Littlefield's got it. Look out. They were thinking about throwing it ahead to Ballou, and then down low, up with a shot, and good is Vance Pfeiffer. Timeout Jaguars, 30-second timeout, and we'll take one as well and be back right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Cinerama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club.
So Waukee, the Warriors, have raced out to a 15-7 lead here early on, and they've done it without their McDonald's All-American scoring a point. It's been everybody else so far. More than just one player there for sure. Winkle to Joey Oki, who's recently into the game with our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Down to the side, Evan Bryan's got it. Nearly lost it out of bounds. He disappears behind the Waukee student section. Shuddy throws it in. Oki up with a shot. He's blocked from behind. Down low they go, stolen out of there. Winkle can't quite come away with it. I apologize. That's not Joey Oki. That's Connor Welsh in the basketball game for the Jaguars. And a foul going to be whistled there away from the basketball. I think they got Shuddy. No, they did not. They got Welsh with a foul. And now for the first time in 5 weeks, Easton Pratt fresh out of a boot back in the game, and he gets a big round of applause from the Jaguars student section as Pratt. Great to see him back in the game now. Always provides a spark when he's on the floor. Long three-point shot on the way from Cooper Randall, no good. Rebound battled around, tipped out of there, and Chase Shuddy comes away with it. Winkle. Thought about the three, back over to Welsh, back to Winkle. Vasky's got it. Pratt, Vasky, 15 seconds on the shot clock. Pratt, down low he goes to Shuddy. Somehow it gets through to Shuddy. Up top it goes, Vasky for three, no good. And rebound tipped out of there and then controlled by Pfeiffer. Pfeiffer 6'9", so not only does Waukee have 6'8", Ballou, they've got 6'9", Pfeiffer. They're a long basketball team out there on the floor. Cade Littlefield's got it right now. Back to Pfeiffer and up top to Mason Costello. Costello free throw line jump shot is good. And it's 17-7. Winkle. Big job running through the screen right there. Ballou ran right through Pratt. Nothing called. They hand it off to Ballou, and he slams it home. First points of the night for Omaha Ballou, and Waukee has opened up a 12-point lead. It's 19-7, and we'll be back right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire, brought to you by these generous local businesses. Nick Girash Fitness, the Ankeny Real Estate Group, Lamberti Goki Lucci Law, Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, U.S. Cellular, Cinerama Ankeny, Wendy Thompson, affiliate of Humble Travel, and Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC.
And we are back here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. 19-7 Waukee in the lead, which may sound like a lot, but in the first game that they only won by three, they actually led by 18 in the first quarter. Easton Pratt for three from the corner, the high arcing shot, no good. Shuddy high up to get the rebound. Welsh back to Pratt. Vasky drives in the lane, has it tipped away, and they're going to say it's on the floor. They'll take the ball out of bounds. One of the biggest crowds of the season we've seen here tonight so far in Centennial. Luke Winkle looks to throw it in. He does. Welsh with the basketball. Over to Pratt, into the middle of the lane. They go Shuddy, the floater in the lane. He gets it to fall. In and out and back in. Little design play for the Jaguars. Take advantage of that middle right now with Ballou out of the game. Deion Jenkins is into the game right now for Waukee. Also with the basketball right now, Jaden Rogers. Rogers was trying to sneak in on the back cut. He doesn't. They kick it out. This is Owen Shipper. Shipper for three. Shipper, good strong stock from up in Parkersburg, Butler County. And it's Waukee by 13. Sure, a lot of the Shipper family is watching up there tonight. 10 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Vasky with the basketball. Up top to Pratt. Jags just having to run the offense from so far away. Pratt goes up with a shot. He's fouled. He'll have a chance for two here. I think they got Shipper for the foul. It is. 6'5 junior whistled for the foul. And Pratt will have an opportunity to shoot two at the free throw line, get the Jags a little bit closer back into this one. First free throw a little bit short, but he wills it in. Evan Bryan and Drew Schurz back into the game with our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitutions. And Pratt gets a second one to fall as well. Waukee gonna get it off actually at the horn. No good. It's a little bit outside, and we head to the second quarter. Waukee's got Centennial doubled up right now. It's 22-11. Back after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency, Summit Family Dental, All-Star Concrete, the Prairie Trail Sports Complex, Joe Bennett Homes, Ankeny Orthodontics, Rainbow of the Heartland, and West 40 Market.
Welcome back to the West 40 Market second quarter. West 40 Market is your one-stop shop for individual cuts of Iowa-raised beef, pork, chicken, bison, turkey, and lamb. From ground meats, steaks, beef snack sticks, brisket, and roast, you'll love the variety of cuts they offer. Located at 315 Southwest Maple Street in Uptown Ankeny, they also carry a variety of local honey, rubs, jams, and sauces. Shop in-store or online for convenient pickup, delivery, or shipping nationwide. Follow them on Facebook or Instagram at West 40 Market. Always love stopping in there and going through the cooler, pick up some snack sticks, and always seems to be some hamburger on sale there. Been told they might even be adding eggs to things here in the near future. Jaguars trailing by 11 here in the second quarter. Luke Winkle with a basketball. He's been quiet in the first half. Easton Pratt for three. Can't get it to fall. Up high to get the rebound for Waukee is Cooper Randall. Ballou spots up for three. Good. In rhythm. Evan Bryan is about 6'5", and he's in the face of Ballou at 6'8", and Ballou looks like he almost dwarfs him out there. And it's Waukee by 14. Winkle. Free throw line jump shot. Can't quite get it through, and Ballou's there for the rebound. Ballou down on the corner they go, and nearly a travel there. Everybody moved when Cooper Randall wasn't expecting it. Long three on the way, no good. Randall's got it back up top, and now Ballou. Three-point shot on the way, no good. An air ball as Easton Pratt corrals the rebound. Evan Bryan now with the ball. Bryan goes into the lane, that little baby hook, and he's found a nice roll for that shot. As Evan Bryan's hot hand continues from the last week. Deion Jenkins throws the ball over to Randall. Ballou draws a double team, taken away. Schurz takes it away. Schurz down to the corner it goes. Evan Bryan thought about the three, kicks it back out. Winkle. Winkle trying to move in on Jenkins. Kicks it out, oh, down to the corner. Easton Pratt's wide open and gets it to fall. Luke Winkle just makes everybody better when he's on the floor. And just like that, it's down to a 9-point lead. Jenkins goes in, he's fouled by Winkle, and he'll have a chance for two free throws. So Jenkins steps up to the free throw line. And that first free throw is a little bit long. Just over 6 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Jack Kirby in the game for the Jaguars for the first time tonight in our Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Jenkins steps up to the free throw line once more. And he hits that one. Back to a 10-point lead for the Warriors. Bucket there for the Jaguars, has it back down to 8. Waukee swings it around. This is Costello. Down low, back to Ballou. Up top to, from Costello. Long ways away. Can't get it. Long rebound, though. Out to Shipper. Hands off to Ballou. Ballou into the lane. Up with a shot. Gets it to not quite fall. I thought it was going to drop. But he's going to have to earn it the hard way at the free throw line. Kirby going to be whistled for the foul. Just the third foul on the Jaguars here with about 5.5 minutes to go in the second quarter. Ballou steps up to the line. First free throw is no good. Pfeiffer back into the ball game for the Warriors. And Ballou calmly sinks that one. It's back to a 9-point lead for Waukee. Winkle to walk it up. He decides to go all the way into the lane, up with a shot, can't get it to fall, and Kirby goes up hard and comes down hard. He's laying on his shoulder. Jack Kirby and Waukee with 4-on-3 and up with a shot. And that's not good for Kirby laying down. He's going to slowly get up. He's back on his feet now. Hit the ground, landed on his left side hard. As he limps off the court. Just landed on everything hard. Nothing really awkwardly. Just landed straight down on that left side as he was high up in the air for the rebound. Waukee comes down, gets a bucket. And now we go back the other way for the Jaguars. Don't forget to stick around after the game. Find out who our Lamberti, Goki, and Lucci Law Player of the Game is. Your local attorneys and the team to fit your legal needs. Reach out to us at LGL Law, 515-964-8777 or online at ankenylaw.com. As the Jaguars retain possession, 24 seconds on the shot clock. Winkle throws it into Vasky. Back to Winkle. He goes in on Ballou. Up with a shot and tries to shoot it around Ballou. Rebound taken out of there by Omaha. As he looks ahead, loses the basketball momentarily, then kicks it out. Three-point shot, an air ball there from Costello. And back the other way is Winkle. Winkle back out. Vasky goes into the lane, and he's going to get fouled by Cooper Randall. Winkle sends it in. Schreurs in the game now. Back up top to Winkle. Winkle defended by Randall. Goes into the lane. The little hook shot in the lane. Can't get it to fall, and Randall gets the rebound. Ballou back the other way for Waukee. Way down to the corner it goes to Jenkins. Thought about the three-point shot. Didn't take it. Randall now with the basketball. And has it taken out of there by Winkle and can't quite hang on to it. Ball's going to get given back to the Warriors. They lob it into Ballou. Ballou backs in, up with a shot, and can't get the shot to fall. And the rebound comes out of there to Shuddy. Winkle pushes it ahead to Evan Bryan. Back to Winkle. Under four to play, Evan Bryan, long three-point shot, no good, and Ballou clears the board. Ballou, oh, that's a nice pass into the lane, spin move. Jenkins, back up top, Randall. Back to Ballou, 20 seconds on the shot clock for the Warriors. And a timeout for Waukee. Coach Kanaski is about 10 feet out on the floor. Asking for a timeout. We'll take a quick one and be back right after this.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency. Springer Floor Care. Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital. Ted Sandine Photography. U.S. Cellular, Made in the Shade, Blinds and More, the Edward Jones Office of Kent Patterson, and Fiscus Jewelers.
So a 3:19 to go here in the second quarter. It is Waukee up by 11. They led by 11 at the end of the first quarter as well. They were on a set play out of the timeout. Ballou, they tracked him down as he cut through the middle. This little field. And then down on the corner, Pfeiffer nearly has it taken away. Cooper Randall, 4 seconds on the shot clock, and he gets it to fall. Good finish there by Cooper Randall. And he puts Waukee back up by 13. Winkle. Back to Evan Bryan. Back to Winkle, kicks it out. Schurz, three-point shot on the way. Good for Drew Schurz. Good time to remind you about the Ankeny Real Estate Group. Visit their website at www.liveankeny.com to find out three ways to sell your home with them. Jaguar students want some defense right now. And the rebound comes out of there to Winkle. A chance to cut into the lead once more for the Jags. Schurz with the basketball. Long three on the way again. Way off. And Littlefield clears the board. Littlefield looking to dribble into almost a triple team there, and he pretty much does. Evan Bryan got a hand on it, but Cooper Randall comes out of there with it for Waukee. 15 seconds on the shot clock. They kick it out. Jenkins drives in, kicks it back out. Randall, three-point shot. Good. Boy, Waukee just on fire. So much attention to their guys that can get the ball in the paint. And then they go and hit these shots from the outside. Winkle with 90 seconds to play in the first half. All the way in, up off the glass, no good. And Ballou up high to get the rebound. Ballou pushes the tempo, and he's going to get fouled by Vasky. Just the fourth team foul on the Jaguars, so a relatively physical game, but just not a whole lot of fouls called. Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution, Easton Pratt, Connor Welsh back in the game for the Jags. That was just Vasky's first foul. And Littlefield. Something happened. I'm not sure what, but the Jaguar fans are going berserk right now. I'm not sure what just happened, but. And on the board, there, Vance Pfeiffer comes up and puts it in. I'm not sure what happened, but a bunch of fans over along the side in the student section just went berserk there on the inbounds play. Luke Winkle now with a basketball for the Jags, trailing by 15. Welsh into the lane, up with a shot. Can't get it to fall. Might have got partially blocked. 15 seconds between the shot and game clock as Randall's got the ball. Randall, long three-point shot, no good. And the rebound to Pratt. Jags get it ahead. Welsh loses the basketball. And it goes out of bounds to the Warriors. Excuse me. There's 0.9 differential. So Waukee could hold basically for the last shot if they wanted to. And it looks like they may do just that, leading by 15. Mason Costello with the ball. Dribbles around, swings it over. And a foul going to be called on the Jaguars. It'll be on Welsh. His second and just a fifth on the team right now, but now Waukee will be able to trigger from underneath the basket with a lot of height out on the floor. Set play as they lob it into the 6'9 Pfeiffer. He backs out, 15 seconds on the clock. Our clock on the cast here is not completely accurate, so can't go off that. Pfeiffer, Ballou. Going to have to heave one up at the horn. He does, and it's no good. Good defense by the Jags at the end. But it's Waukee leading 36-21 here at the break. We'll take a quick break ourselves and be back right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Time. They're all up here with me. It's not really a dance family. It's all right. Here you go. That's all right. She likes to make it difficult. Yeah. All right. We are back here on our halftime show with Ankeny Centennial head girls basketball coach Scott DeYoung. Coach, got to find all my notes here tonight. You guys won by a lot. Sorry. Lost it here. There we go. Final tonight, 36-55
over
Waukee.
Well, it wasn't as easy as it looked. Waukee's got a really good team. They've had some really good wins. They've improved. And, you know, you just can't have a night off, and we haven't. And so I thought mostly a lot of positives tonight.
I was really impressed by Sophia Hope for them, just a you know, tall junior that knows her way around the lane especially.
Well, then she hit that little step back three right away, you know, and it just swish, and she could drive it. And Avery Porter's defense on number two, Hawks, is I mean, she's a really, really, really good player, and I think she had 5 points, has had 18, 17. I think the last five games she's averaging 17 points. So we did a really, really good job on her.
You guys continue to roll right now. I guess as you look at things, you know, we talk every week, I feel like, about Maya Crawford and just what she's brought to this team right now with her toughness on defense. You know, you can tell tonight getting a little frustrated on the offensive end. You know, the bunnies, she gets moving fast. Yeah, I mean, like, she does. She gets moving fast. But, I mean, it does not affect her defense. You see her
right.
Continue to play hard, and I love that about her.
It seems like nothing affects our defense, and that's the good news. But, you know, we got so many sophomores on our team, and you think they're veterans, but they're really just young pups yet. I don't think most of them have their license, but we had 4 players in double figures, and that's great. And the one that didn't was Avery Porter. She had 9 assists, so we had no offensive rebounds the first half, which was shocking. We had 13 the second half, so just a lot of really good things.
Kennedy White running the floor gets a lot of buckets that way. Just, you know, you don't think of her as necessarily a full-court player, but she finds herself kind of behind the defense, sneaky fast a lot of times.
She does, and the one McKenna had, I thought, McKenna, what are you doing? And then Kennedy went and caught it in traffic and scored, which is a bit, those are big baskets, you know, when it's hard to score and you get some of those transition hoops.
So a couple of your cohorts out there, Coach Mark High and Coach Jess Reinhardt, being recognized for a lot of victories. Coach High with, I think, 500. I think he got this last summer as a baseball coach, and Coach Reinhardt with her semifinal volleyball team got 300 this year in her 10 years with the Jaguars. So some great coaches that you get to work with up here at Centennial.
Well, no, there's a great administration, great coaches, and probably the most importantly, great players and good kids. Because as you well know, that's what it takes. So we've got a fun group. We really enjoyed these kids. And, you know, it's starting to get down there. We got 4 games left, I think.
It's crazy. I had Taylor Anderson at halftime of your game and talking about just the postseason coming up right now. And the season has just flown by.
It has. And I think we've kept practicing really good. I mean, I don't remember the last time I thought we had a bad practice. And we had a bye week, which was an extra couple practices. And I thought the kids really responded. And you know, if you keep practicing well, you're going to get better, and I think we have. We've improved.
As we look towards the postseason, you know, you talk a lot about your sophomores, and they've been so good, but you know as well as anybody, it's your senior class. It's that leadership, and they're the ones that carry you if you're going to make a long run. And I think watching McKenna Clark, what she's been able to do lately, she runs the floor so well. Even saw a little step back jumper out of her tonight, and boy, if she can develop that one right now, that's really tough to defend.
She's been playing great. I mean, it's everybody and I, they were putting hard pressure on it too, because I talked about how she's a great defender too and makes it really hard, harder than you realize. And McKenna handled it well. She was hitting her shots tonight and distributing the ball, getting us in her offense. And only thing I would notice of McKenna, her defense is so much improved from last year, which gives us 5 really strong defenders on the floor at one time, which makes us really, really good on defense.
Yeah, and so you make it difficult for teams to score. If you hold teams to 36, I like your chances.
Yeah.
As we looked at the postseason right now, you and the CIML, the teams playing in the CIML, I mean, you got to look at it as it's going to be a battle down at state with a lot of teams in the CIML. I mean, obviously you got to get there first, but the seedings are playing their way out right now, that it looks like there's going to be a lot of teams that you've played already playing down at Wells Fargo.
Oh, yeah, you know, and you're going to have to play somebody really good to get to state, because I don't know how many teams we got in our conference, 8? I mean, there's 7 or 8 teams that could be state tournament teams. So we have a state tournament game or a regional final game basically every game. So we're all hardened and tournament tested. It's just a matter of who you're going to have to play to get there.
Well, and a couple of those teams you got remaining on your schedule, Southeast Polk and Johnston, I mean, they're –
And Ankeny.
Yeah.
Waukee Northwest.
Right. Yeah.
Let's not forget about them.
Yeah, I mean, we're talking, I think 3 of those teams are in the top 8 right now.
Yeah.
So
we got Johnson next. You know, they've just been an awesome run, and it'll be a good challenge for us. And, you know, we're excited for that.
Well, Coach, want to appreciate or thank you for coming back
Absolutely.
Up here again. We got one more opportunity to do this.
Yeah, last home game. It's hard to believe.
Coming up,
really,
so we have the Hawks here in, what, about 10 more days, I think we've got that one coming up. So, again, the
Thanks for
Jags,
having us. Appreciate
absolutely.
It.
The Jags victorious tonight, 55-36. Excuse me, one more win for the Jaguars. So we'll take another break and be back right after this. It's the Lincoln Savings Bank Halftime Show here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Cinerama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Drosh Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
What does it mean for Lincoln Savings Bank to be more than a bank? You know how a library used to be a place you went to find a book using the Dewey Decimal System, which you never really understood? Well, the modern library is a place where providing access to books is one of many offerings. Lincoln Savings Bank is more than just a place you get your mortgage from and have your checking account. It is also a place you get insurance. It's a place you can get financial planning advice. It's a place you can do college planning. Have I made my point? Lincoln Savings Bank, more than a bank.
And we're back here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. I want to thank the girls' head basketball coach, Scott DeYoung, for joining us here on our halftime break, sponsored by Lincoln Savings Bank. We also want to talk tonight. One of the things we haven't mentioned, there's a new facility here in town. It's going to be great for our Ankeny youth to have an opportunity to get in the gym and shoot a lot more. Open gyms quite frequently, the premier indoor youth sports facility. Excuse me, I can't talk right now. In Iowa right now is open right here in Ankeny. The field house at the Prairie Trail Sports Complex. They'll offer boys and girls basketball tournaments, volleyball tournaments, hit tracks leagues for softball and baseball. Visit Prairie Trail SC for details on tournaments, leagues, and other events here in the Ankeny community. Also want to be sure and thank U.S. Cellular. At U.S. Cellular, we care about our customers and communities as always. Tonight's live stream is powered by U.S. Cellular's 5G network. We've got all our computers, cameras, everything are hooked up to that 5G network located just north of Northview Middle School and right across from the Ankeny Sonic. Come check out America's locally grown wireless at U.S. Cellular. This is the Rainbow of the Heartland third quarter. Parents and grandparents, check out Rainbow of the Heartland in Grimes for the best in swing sets, basketball hoops, courts, and trampolines. They also offer commercial playgrounds and have been Iowa's playground superstore for over 25 years. Call 1-800-RAINBOW or visit rainbowoftheheartland.com. Waukee in their gray road uniforms has the ball here to start the second half. That's Ballou. Up top here, this is Littlefield. Littlefield did some damage, finds himself open from 10 feet away, leaves it short, and Evan Bryan gets the rebound. Waukee got out to their 15-point halftime lead, and they did it without Omaha Ballou scoring much at all. He wasn't in foul trouble. He just had all his teammates doing the scoring for him. So much attention on the McDonald's All-American, future Iowa State Cyclone, who lead, by the way, right now at home tonight against top 10 Kansas State. Coach Otzelberger trying to get another big win in the Cyclones' resume. Winkle throws it in there to Schurz, back up top to Winkle. 30 seconds into the third quarter, no one scored here yet. Shuddy decides to cut loose with a three-point shot, can't hit it. Cooper Randall comes out of there for Waukee. All the way in he goes, hands it off to Ballou, backing in, up with a shot, and good. He's right there by the rim when he turns around. Just right there. Makes it easy, and it's the Warriors by 17. Winkle. Free throw line, jump shot. Can't quite get it to fall, and out of there with the rebounds, Mason Costello. Ballou once again. Lobs it down low, and they're going to say Shuddy held on to Cade Littlefield. Excuse me, not Littlefield, Pfeiffer. Just the first foul on Shuddy. Littlefield into Ballou. No one is on him for a second. One athletic move by Ballou, but he couldn't get it up. Winkle going to go one on two. All the way in, athletic move, and can't get it up off the glass. Left it short. Waukee comes back the other way. Littlefield all the way in, up off the glass, and good. Boy, that little stutter from about 17 feet away. Littlefield found himself wide open under the basket, and it is Waukee by 19. Winkle into the lane, and there's going to be foul whistled down there on Costello, I believe. Both officials put their arms up and looked at each other and waited for who was going to make the call, and they did call it on Randall, actually. Jaguars getting the ball into Brian. Evan Bryan all the way in. Time for the baby hook. No, kicks it out. Schurz for three. Long ways out, no good. Rebound tracked down, and Costello's got it. Jags going to have to heat up from three to get back into this one. Littlefield kicks it out to Costello, up with a shot, and no good. Rebound tipped around, and out of there with it's Cooper Randall. Oh, wow, what a move there. Costello goes in and gives Waukee their biggest lead of the night now as they've doubled up the Jags. It's 42-21. Winkle nearly loses the basketball. Does, but it lands up in the hands of Schurz. Back out to Schurz. Vasky, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Shuddy backs in, back out to Vasky. Vasky step back three, in and out, no good. It's been all Warriors here to start the third quarter. Down low. Pfeiffer backing in on Shuddy, and he throws it away, and it's going to go out of bounds way on the other end. And we'll see where they spot the ball right now. Substitution for the Warriors right now. Deion Jenkins comes into the game along with Owen Shipper. And the Jaguars are going to get the basketball way down here at this end. So Vasky throws it into Winkle. 4:40 to play here in the third quarter. Winkle dribbles it off his foot, out of bounds, and the ball will go back to the Warriors. So Ballou to take the ball out of bounds right now as Waukee Jenkins pushes it ahead. 4.5 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Ballou up top. I've been told we've got a scoreboard issue at the moment, so may not see that here for a little bit. Littlefield throws it down to Ballou, backing in. Draws a double team right away. Back up top. Look at Waukee sharing the ball. Jenkins wide open. Three good. 45-21. Waukee in the lead. Shuddy. Down low, Vasky up with a shot. Good for Evan Vasky. Nick Vasky, excuse me. Jenkins doesn't waste any time for Waukee. Looking down low. Shipper backing down Shuddy. Kicks it out, Littlefield. Just inside the free throw line, gets it to fall. 47-23, Waukee in the lead. 3:25 to go in the third quarter. Winkle. Points have been hard to come by here in the third for the Jags. They've only scored two. Vasky's got it. Throws it to Shuddy. Back to Vasky. Into the lane, up with a shot, and can't get it to go. Littlefield away with the rebound. Look out. Littlefield. Once more, Jenkins for three. Waukee just on fire right now. They lead by 27. And timeout for the Jaguars. Need a break. We'll take one as well and be back right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency. Cinerama Ankeny. Discus Jewelers. Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC. 72 Degrees, your comfort company. The New York Life Office of Josh Cowart. Rock Valley Physical Therapy. And the Iowa Rush Soccer Club.
And we're back here on the Rainbow of the Heartland third quarter, where Waukee has opened up a 27-point lead on the Jaguars. They've been red hot from three, but they've been open looks. And Waukee making the Jaguars pay for really collapsing into the lane and trying to take away their big men. And Waukee has just been on fire from three-point land here tonight. Jaguars will have the ball out of bounds here on the sideline. Easton Pratt, good to see him back for the first time tonight, for the first time in about 5 weeks. Winkle, who's been quiet tonight. Dribbles into the lane and has it taken away. Littlefield for three, good again. Wow. So many teams this year just seem to shoot lights out from three against the Jaguars. It's a 30-point lead for Waukee. Three-pointer from Schurz. Good. Drew Schurz providing the spark tonight for the Jags. Their Ankeny Real Estate Group three-pointer, www.liveankeny.com. Figure out three ways to sell your home in Ankeny. Jags come away with a steal. Pratt hands off to Winkle. Winkle kicks it out. Schurz, no thought about three. Welsh into the game. Pratt all the way in. Back out to Welsh. And there's going to be a foul whistled there on Waukee. It's going to be whistled on Jaden Rogers for the Warriors. Dowling is way ahead of Ankeny down on the south side of town here tonight as Pratt drops into the lane. Fadeaway shot. Can't get it to fall. Rebound out there to Owen Shipper. Littlefield pushes it ahead. Jenkins down low they go. And before the shot on the floor, Pfeiffer got fouled, and I think they're going to get Welsh. It is Welsh. Third foul on Welsh with 91 seconds to go here in the third quarter. They lob it in to Pfeiffer. Pfeiffer just bullies his way through. Up with a shot and good. Three-point shot on the way from Schurz. Boy, he stays hot. Jenkins. Hands off to Shipper. Back to Jenkins. 50 seconds to play here in the third. Littlefield. Down low they go to Shipper. Backs his way in, kicks it out. Three-point shot on the way from Pfeiffer, no good. One of the very few that Waukee has missed so far here tonight. Easton Pratt now with the basketball. Hands off to Winkle. About a second and a half difference between the shot clock and the game clock. 21 on the shot clock. Jags holding for one as they trail by 26. Winkle goes to work with seven, up with a shot. Good, the basket counts. And he'll have a chance for a three-point play with 7.6 seconds to go in the third quarter. Deion Jenkins whistled for his first foul, and just four on Waukee. And Winkle with a chance at the free throw line to complete the three-point play. And he gets it. Jenkins pushes it ahead. Waukee's going to have a chance here at the horn. Back up top, Jenkins, 2 seconds, 1 second. Step back, there it is, no good at the horn. 55-32, Waukee leads at the end of the third quarter. We'll be back with the final 8 minutes after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weicker Realtors, the 515 Agency. Summit Family Dental. All-Star Concrete. The Prairie Trail Sports Complex. Joe Bennett Homes. Ankeny Orthodontics. Rainbow of the Heartland. And West 40 Market.
Fans, after the game tonight and every night, head over to Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill and try some of their great food and drinks. Celebrate the Jaguar victories over there. I know we've been there for a lot of post-game gatherings, pre-game gatherings, you name it, lunch, afternoon happy hours. Make sure to head on over to Cabaret Sports Bar and Grill, huge supporters of everything in Ankeny. Love their tenderloins at lunch, great pizza. And my new favorite, the buffalo chicken wrap. Get it with the tater tots and thank me later. Centennial with a basketball, trailing by 23 right now as we head into the fourth quarter. Down in the corner, Pratt kicks it out. Welsh, now they go to Schurz. He's the hot hand and can't quite get it through after a couple chances at it. Ball's tipped around. No one wants the hot potato. Pratt muscles it up through and he's going to get fouled. Costello whistled for that foul. Fans starting to file out here tonight. Tall task for the Jaguars to get back into this one. But right now with the clock stopped, maybe a chance to dig in a little bit more. Back to a 22-point lead. Make it 21 after Pratt. Coming off the bench for the first time in about 5 weeks. So Waukee tries to get it in, they throw it away. Turnover quick back to the Jags. Coach Kanaski is not happy with that decision there of who was doing what. So make sure everybody's on the same page here heading forward there for Waukee. And now the Jags a chance to get it back under 20. Winkle swings it over to Vasky. Back to Winkle. Winkle out. Schurz for three. Can't get that to fall, but Pratt there for the rebound once again. Hands it off. Shuddy up off the right hand and good, and it's back to a 19-point lead. Jaguars trying to scratch and claw back into this one. Costello kicks it ahead there to Randall down in the corner. That's Jaden Rogers. Randall going to let loose that three-point shot. Barely draws any iron. In fact, caught everybody off guard. Then bullying into the lane there is Evan Jacobson, the 6'6 freshman. And he'll have a chance for two free throws. Pratt whistled for his first foul and just a third on the Jaguars. So Jacobson again, the 6'6 freshman with a chance here at the free throw line, hits the first. Back to a 20-point lead for the Warriors. Evan Bryan back in the game with our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Don't forget to stick around after the game to find out who our Lamberti, Goki, and Lucci Law Player of the Game is. Your local attorneys and a team to fit your legal needs. Reach out to us at LGL Law, 515-964-8777, or online at AnkenyLaw.com. Luke Winkle with the basketball for the Jaguars. In on Ballou. Little spin move there. Winkle gets it to fall. Full timeout for the Jaguars. We'll take a quick break to check the Cyclone score and be back right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Whiter Realtors, the 515 Agency, Springer Floor Care, Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital, Ted Sandine Photography, U.S. Cellular, Made in the Shade, Blinds and More, the Edward Jones Office of Kent Patterson, and Fiscus Jewelers.
And we're back here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire, where Waukee got out to a quick 15-8 lead tonight, just a few minutes into the game, and they've really never looked back. They've led by as many as 26, and they lead right now by 18 with 6:38 to go in this one. They get it into Ballou. Jags putting pressure on in the backcourt. Ballou dribbles through, gets it ahead. Swings through, and now Waukee to Ballou in the lane. Wow. Omaha Ballou dribbles it up and off the give and go, hammers it home, and it's back to a 20-point lead. Evan Bryan for three for the Jags. Can't get it to fall, and the rebound comes out of there to Vance Pfeiffer. Ballou, three-point shot on the way. Good. Almost felt like the Jags had a chance to get back into it, and a 5-0 Omaha Ballou run as Waukee back up top by 23. Winkle trying to go point for point with him, and he does. Little free throw line jump shot for Winkle. Ballou up top once again as they swing it around. Costello. Oh, nice defense there by Evan Bryan. They missed the travel, but Vance Pfeiffer goes up and lays it in. And it's Jaguar basketball. Again, Winkle into the lane, up with a shot, good. Luke Winkle with some late game heroics here for the Jaguars. Might be too little too late now as we approach the 5-minute mark of this one. Ballou's got it up top right now, covered by Shuddy. Into the lane, Ballou, foul. They'll have a chance for two free throws. Shuddy whistled for that one. Ballou takes his time at the free throw line, lines it up. And gets it to fall. His future team, the Iowa State Cyclones, trail Kansas State tonight at home at halftime, 33-31. And just got the message that Dowling has swept Ankeny tonight on both the girls' and boys' side. Ballou gets that one to fall. 65-42. Waukee in the lead. Winkle stripped away, out of bounds. It will stay with the Jaguars. 25 seconds on the shot clock. Ballou They get it in, bullying his way in. Vasky up off the glass and in. Now 4.5 minutes to play in this one. Swing out Jenkins, had a couple threes here tonight. Ballou in on Shuddy, in the lane, up with a shot, and just so much strength there from Omaha Ballou once he gets into the lane, and he's shown he can make the shot from outside as well. Winkle spots up for three. He was fouled hard, nothing called, and it's going to go off of Pfeiffer out of bounds and stay with the Jaguars. 4:10 to go in the ballgame. Easton Pratt back in the game. Pratt has the basketball. To Shuddy, drawing the double team now. He takes it back out. Pratt, long three-point shot on the way, way off. And the rebound pulled out of there by Cooper Randall. Jaguars look to find positives out of the last 4 minutes of this one as Randall backs it back out there to Pfeiffer. And then the shot by Costello almost goes in, and Winkle comes up to get the basketball. Vasky coming down and goes up right into Ballou. Ballou gets a piece of it and then stolen out of there by Welsh. Pratt dribbles into the lane, kicks it out. Here we go, Vasky for three. Good. Jenkins swings it over to here to Randall. Randall all the way into the lane, up off the glass, no good. Ballou gets the board and takes up. He's fouled, basket counts. And Omaha Ballou just a force to be reckoned with down there for Waukee. Oh, and he gets the ball down on the block. He can do whatever he wants to do. Caden Ivory checking into the game right now for Waukee, as well as Jaden Rogers. Jack Kirby is back in the game. That's a good sign for Centennial fans as Shuddy takes a seat in our Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Kirby went down earlier after he went up high for a rebound, but good to see him back in the game. Ballou steps up to the free throw line. Hits another one. Ballou has a seat for what may be the final time this evening. And Winkle walks the ball up for the Jaguars. Winkle, free throw line jumper is good, and they'll have a chance to complete the three-point play. Saw this at the end of the girls' game. They did not let up on the whistles, so things got drug out quite a bit. Jacobson, the freshman, back in the game for Waukee. Man, they've got so much length out there. Just keep coming at you with tall bodies. Winkle gets the free throw. So back down to 20 with 3 minutes to go, and then on the inbounds play, foul going to be whistled on Welsh. And that should be 1-1, I believe. Oh, just a sixth, okay. So Jaden Rogers looks to throw it in. He does to Jenkins. Jags try to set up the trap. Back over here to Ivory and back to Jenkins. Three-point shot on the way there from Jacobson was no good, but Waukee clears the rebound. Jenkins now left wide open for three. Can't hit it. And Connor Welsh gets the board. 2.5 minutes to go in this one. Ahead to Vasky. Vasky up off the glass. Left it short. Rebound out of there to the Warriors. What started off as a very excited, loud crowd tonight is faded away right now as Waukee has just flexed their muscle as the number two team in the state, maybe the best team in the state. As that ball's tipped out of there, Kirby comes away with the steal. Winkle in on Ivory, shoots a three, no good, and Pratt tries to keep the rebound in, and it is off of Rogers, I believe they said. At first I thought he whistled as a foul, but no, just off of Rogers, And the ball will stay with the Jags. Joey Oakey back, well, not, excuse me, not back in the game, into the game for the first time tonight for the Jags. He's got the ball right now. Welsh to Pratt. Loses a basketball momentarily. Welsh all the way in, up off the glass, and good for Connor Welsh. Waukee, that's Shipper with the basketball, hands it off. Now Jenkins has it. Under two to go in this one. Ivory to Jenkins. And nearly tied up, almost taken away. Ivory comes up with it. Down in the corner, Jenkins. 10 seconds on the shot clock. And nice free throw line extended jump shot there by Jaden Rogers. Winkle. Let's loose a shot from the free throw line, and it comes up and back down. Little discussion here. The basket's going to count. Said it never caught any part of the top of the backboard, so it will count. Gets it down on 18-point lead, and now substitutions all over the place. In the game for Waukee, looks like we've got Carlos Kirui. Ryan Gretman has the ball stolen away. Kirby goes all the way down, up with a shot, and good. Under a minute to go for Waukee. This is Calvin Flood now with the basketball. They swing it out. That's don't have 34. I don't have who that is. Another steal out of there for the Jags. Oakey gets it ahead to Welsh. Welsh can't get it to fall. Kirby there for the rebound. He puts it up and in. And now 35 seconds to go. Down to a 14-point lead as they hand off to Flood. Swings it up top here. This is Keyshawn Moore in the game. And rebound out of there. This is Oki. 17 seconds to go. That may be the final score here tonight. Ball tipped around. Waukee comes out of there with it. 5 seconds, they're not going to do anything with it. And that's going to be our final tonight. 72-58, Waukee. It's won now several in a row, and we will take a break and be back right after this.
Winter sports coverage on Centennial Digital is driven by Freedom Tire and brought to you by these generous local businesses. Weichert Realtors, the 515 Agency, Cinerama Ankeny, Discus Jewelers, Lincoln Savings Bank, member FDIC, 72 Degrees, your comfort company, the New York Life Office of Josh Cowart, Rock Valley Physical Therapy, and the Iowa Rush Soccer Club.
Welcome back to the postgame show here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. It was a split tonight. Waukee boys come out of here in the nightcap with a 72-58 win over the Centennial boys. They led all the way through, sprinted out to a 15-8 lead just a couple minutes of the game. They led 36-21 at half, 55-32 at the end of the third quarter, and the final tonight, 72-58. Our Lamberti, Goki, and Lucci Law player of the game is Drew Schurz tonight. Drew kept the team in the game with his three-point shooting and tough defense, and he is our LGL Law player of the game. In the early game tonight, it was the Jaguars moving on to 13-4 on the season in girls basketball. They beat Waukee tonight and may move up. They're ranking right now as sixth in the final rankings before the seedings come out next week. The Jaguars won that game 55-36. We've got some time off now. Well, I take that back. We don't. We're back in action Tuesday night. It's official. We will be streaming the regional wrestling duels here at Ankeny Centennial. That'll be 6 o'clock, the first matchup between Dowling and Carlisle. And then after that, the winner will take on Centennial. They'll wrestle Centennial with a winner of that going on to the state dual wrestling meet. So we want to thank several businesses who have come together, been inundated with businesses today that have said they'd like to make sure that our streams continue throughout the postseason. We want to thank them as well, and we'll be sure to give them their due as this postseason happens. If you'd like to be a postseason sponsor of ours here on Centennial Digital, please let us know. Head to our Facebook page. You can message us there, or centennialjagsdigital@gmail.com. For the whole crew tonight at Centennial Digital, I want to thank all the fans that were watching, and it's time for us to go now.